I'm immigration attorney Heather Poole, and today I will be talking about misrepresentation waivers for immigrants who do not yet have their green cards. For more information about me, stay tuned until the end of the video to learn more about my extensive experience in this area. When you are applying for permanent residency or a green card, or an immigration benefit of any kind, intentionally concealing the truth from or knowingly lying to an immigration or a consulate officer could result in a misrepresentation finding. This could also happen if you lie on a form or if you lie to a CBP officer at the port of entry, which includes at an airport. If CIS or the Department of State consulate officer believes you committed misrepresentation, this is a lifetime bar to receiving any immigration benefit, regardless of whether you otherwise qualify for a permanent residency or a visa. This is very serious. The only way around a misrepresentation finding is filing a waiver with CIS. Waivers are a big undertaking and should be taken very seriously, be well documented, and indicate that the immigrant applying for the waiver deserves it. So who can qualify for a misrepresentation waiver? For a waiver to be approved, the immigrant must have a qualifying relative. This means that the immigrant must have either a U.S. citizen spouse or a U.S. citizen parent or a U.S. lawful permanent residency spouse or parent who would suffer extreme hardship if the immigrant is not allowed to reenter the United States. There is a special exception for battered spouses. Note that children are not considered qualifying relatives for this waiver unless you have an approved vow of self petition. So, what is extreme hardship? This is an elusive term. The key term in the provision is extreme, and thus only in cases of real, actual, or prospective injury to the United States citizen or lawful permanent resident parent or spouse will the bar be removed. Common results of the bar, such as separation from a loved one, financial difficulties, loss of education, they are themselves insufficient to warrant approval of an application unless combined with much more extreme factors or impact on the U.S. citizen or permanent resident spouse or parent. Applicants are encouraged to submit as much documentary evidence as possible, proving that failure to receive the waiver requested would result in extreme hardship to the U.S. citizen spouse or parent. Consulates differ on what factors in a case are more persuasive than others. The largest consulate in the world with the most waiver applications is Ciudad Juarez, Mexico. In 2005, the CIS office attached to this consulate considered the following as type of factors that are relevant to deciding whether the U.S. citizen parent or spouse will suffer extreme hardship. The consulate said it would also consider other factors and continues to follow some of these. Health is an important reason. Is there a need for ongoing or specialized treatment requirements for physical or mental condition? Availability and quality of such treatment in the foreign country, anticipated duration of treatment, and more. They will also consider financial considerations, the ability for the U.S. citizen to be employed abroad, loss of a home, decline in standard of living. The CIS office may also consider education as a factor. Loss of opportunity for higher education, loss of a program, such as a college program if you're halfway through it, or loss of scholarships could work. There are additional factors that you can use beyond this list. Those additional factors can include personal considerations, such as the number of close relatives in the United States that you have in the United States, or close relatives that you have outside of the United States, and other special factors such as fear of returning to your home country because of societal stigma or ostracization, or fear of being hunted by the police. Extreme hardship is not something that's easily defined. I suggest you talk with an experienced waiver attorney about your options and whether your case has a chance of success. I am an expert in complex family-based immigration cases and have a 98% approval rate for the past 12 years. I'm a nationally published immigration author and frequent public speaker on immigration topics. I regularly train other immigration lawyers on complicated marriage and family immigration cases for the American Immigration Lawyers Association, Federal Bar Association, and national legal education providers. I represent clients all over the U.S., traveling to immigration interviews and deportation proceedings. Visit our website, humanrightsattorney.com, for more in-depth information and articles on complex family immigration issues.